I arrived here as a young faculty member in the fall of 1968, and this campus was torn apart. When I arrived, I found that students were divided among themselves, students were divided from faculty, faculty were split. It was almost chaotic.
The status quo at that time was unconscionable. It was time for a change, whatever the price.
In the late 1960s that was of an extraordinary nature. I think that a good many of us felt that it was rather incumbent upon us to rebel in one form or another. That doesn't mean necessarily picking up a gun and shooting soldiers. What it means was to not accept things as they were and to at least investigate them, if not to change them.
I guess it's the fact that they don't know. They don't know what's going on behind it. I mean, we didn't know, I didn't know anything that's going on behind it until it happened to my major. When it happened to my major and people started informing me of what I wanted or what I needed to know, that's when I started getting mad and started wanting to have my voice. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the main problem here at Mission, is that no one knows what's really going on.
Right.
Even if we are here, there's a lot of teachers that just tell the students when they ask them, it's like, oh no, they're just a bunch of misinformed kids. They don't know what's really going on.
What do you think the culture on campus is, and why do you think it is the way that it is?
That's a pretty complex topic. I think that, first of all, I've been here for 15 years. I think that there's multiple perspectives. You know, you have the perspective from the president or the administrator, you'll have the faculty perspective, you'll have the student perspective, and somewhere maybe even the community perspective. I think that sometimes what's really happening and what people are saying is happening are really two separate things. So I think, unfortunately, on this campus we have a habit of not really taking care of issues. And they're regular institutional issues, issues of hiring, issues of evaluating, issues of communicating information, issues of even just, you know, get-togethers, social gatherings, so that people get to know each other.
So what do you guys know anything about student government? ASO, anything like that?
No idea about it.
No, it exists. That's about it.
No, I actually don't. I haven't even seen, like, anything around here, like, no posters.
I have no idea what that is, actually.
I don't.
Honestly, I don't really know much about the student government here on campus.
I know. So, are you ladies voting next week?
We have 7 positions available within ASO. So, right before we close up, again, I want to thank everyone for coming out. But we have our student trustee candidate here. I'm going to have him speak. But right now, I want to get questions from the audience.
Well, I think the culture sucks, to be honest, though. I mean, the way it feels when you're in campus, it's like, it makes you not even want to be at school. So it's kind of like, the culture is like, you just come to class and boom, you really got to go home.
They're taking community out of community colleges.
We as students need to change the way we act and what we expect and demand accountability for our education.
I mean, if we had students with that mentality, our school wouldn't be where it is today, where kids just come for the money and they don't come for the classes. They don't come to get the education that is here that their teachers want to give them. And they would be, I mean, our graduation percentage would be so much higher than the 12% that it is.
12%, that's where we're at?
I believe so, yes.
Okay, I think I heard that too.
So if students were, and the faculty would be able to push that, and the ASO come and give a voice to the students, let them say what they want to say, and let them, fight for their rights as students, I believe our school would be a better school.
The only way this government responds to
would respond to any pressure for change would be if there was significant pressure for change, and I think that that's what political movements are.
Us being out here for a teacher has led to like a bunch of other things, and like all these other things coming to light, like about how.
Like if I hear at a hotel, you wouldn't want to stay here if you're looking at the floor. Like looking at the floor alone, like that's supposed to be white, and that's like an off brown gray.
It's on 12.
I mean, only 12, that's if somebody cleaned it last night. If.
And all those walls are clearly fingerprinted and kid marks. This is just not a level of respect that can be viewed as, you know, I appreciate you guys being here. I want you to succeed. It's not an environment that is conducive to having that. You know?
We really are focusing on getting students their education and transferring. It's, you know, if we lived on campus and you have something different that's not that commuter feel, it would be probably a little bit different. But it's almost like because of the way that this is set up as a community college, it is for students just to complete requirements and leave, get a degree and leave, get a skill and leave or certificate, then there really isn't a lot of home to just hang out, and there's no time, and there's no, we don't even have a place yet really for people to just kind of hang out and talk about, you know, things and, you know, like you would in a coffee shop. It's only teenage
wasteland. That everyone thinks Pierce College is so good is an idea put off. I would say by our administration, it's sort of propaganda, but they're very good at promoting, oh, we're very great, and I think they really focus on the money. Also, the honors program is fairly nice. I don't think anyone who's been through the honors program at Pierce has not been accepted to UCLA. But other than that, Pierce College, I'm going to say 90% to even higher of the students on campus don't care about anything going on here.